What's up? It's your boy Weezy, baby. Y'all might know me as Lil Wayne, Cash Money Millionaire, President and CEO. Holla at your boy.
Stepping at the motherfucking court, day and out. I'm looking like a star, bitch. When you see me, make a wish. Holla at your motherfucking ball, JR. Birdman, my paw, bitch. Ball, bread, born rich. Dear Mr. Toilet, I'm the shit. Got these other haters pissed, cause my toilet paper thick, I know. But tripping at 40, make a chip out of potato head wimp. Then like ranch, I dip.
The latest thing popping off right now with me and my music, I just dropped my latest album, which is my fifth solo album called The Carter 2. First week sales, 244,000. That's the best ever by any Cash Money artist ever. Number two in the country, number one on R&B charts. So as far as my music right now, I'm guessing this is where I need to be. Well, I'm from a neighborhood called Holland Grove, from a street called Apple and Eagle. So by me being the only child, I was always a wanderer, so I never played in front of the house. I mean, I wandered off to Apple and Eagle Street, where it was really going down at, and nobody wasn't my age around there. So everything I started doing was what they been doing, but I started at 11, at the age of 11. Everything. I even signed my contract at the age of 11. But we were still staying in the same hood. And mind you, we were staying in an apartment complex. Well, you may see it and not think it's an apartment complex. It may just look like the hood to you, but it was the apartment complex of the hood. My homie, he was playing, him and his homie was playing with a gun. His homie incidentally shot him in the thigh. Then 3 weeks later, I end up playing with a pistol and shooting myself in the chest, 2 inches from my heart, and end up living. So after the punishment, of course I was punished after that. After the punishment and after I got back on the street, it really wasn't nothing. That, you know what I mean? By me being so young and at a tender age of 12, it didn't really hit me like nothing hit me to be like, yo, take life seriously. I went right back to the same corner like, yo, check me out. And niggas was like, nigga, you stupid. I was like, yeah, I know, I was tripping. Such and such. And then it was an old conversation. I'm just a nigga, not a nigga from the hood that got shot. The way I met Baby and Slim was, the day I met Baby and Slim was Friday the 13th, May 1993. It was a Cash Money Records autograph signing at a record store called Odyssey Records in my hood, Carrollton. So they also had a rapper on their label from my hood by the name of Lil Slim. And Lil Slim had heard me rapping before. Prior to that autograph signing, he heard me rapping. So he told me that he would tell them about me. I never believed the dude, but when I got to the autograph signing, he was like, yo, Baby and Slim, this the dude I told y'all about. I was like 11 years old. They asked me to spit, I spit. And I wasn't talking about ABC 123, you know what I mean? So that shocked him like this. And then it was like, so who write that? And I was like, me. And it was like, well, your brothers. I was like, ain't none. It's like, who your daddy is? It's like, I ain't got none. So, you know what I mean? So they was like, wait, there's something different about you, you know what I mean? So that was that. We went from there. Handling the position of CEO, president of Cash Money Records, you have to give it, blame it on my loyalty. That's what it all is right there, and that comes from me being me. The only people you could say I looked up to was Baby and Slim, and I guess I saw how they stay loyal to each other. It's really how Baby and Slim or how B, and they really stay loyal to a situation, you know what I mean? I watched them, you know what I mean, when other things was popping, niggas was like, nah, we gonna do this, you know what I mean? When it was just totally uncool to do that shit, you know what I mean? Like, even in my hood, when I was going back to my hood, nigga, and niggas was like, I had a big dispute in my hood. Niggas was telling me I want to represent another hood just because I had to represent the way Cash Money was representing. And it's just how loyal Baby and them was, but that's how loyal I was too at the time. I got a Hot Boy right there on my, my trigger, position, my pulling trigger position. Got my pop right there in memory of Rabbits up to me. Lost my pop when I was 14. It's my nigga. The Carter above that, y'all know who that is. I got Where Would I Be Without Slim and Baby. It's like one of my first tattoos. Baby right there. My mom right there. I love Miss Sita. This C right here in my forehead also is for her. My mom. I put them on my eyelids so when I close my eyes and if I'm facing you and if you thinking I'm scared or I fear anything that you doing or say or got or can do, only thing I'm gonna fear is God. So try me, bring it to my doorstep and I promise I'll answer. Well, the Hurricane Katrina thing, I mean, as far as affecting my album, I didn't get the luxury of recording in my hometown, New Orleans, so that was probably a different sense of comfort there, because when I'm at home, you know what I mean, I know I'm home. Now I had to relocate because of Hurricane Katrina to Miami. And as far as Hurricane Katrina affected me, I just called my homie, just now he's back in New Orleans right now going to a funeral from somebody they just found from that whole thing right there. So, I mean, it's still crazy. It's more serious than a lot of people know. But as far as affecting me, I don't let nothing affect me. You know what I mean? I don't let nothing affect me. If you do, then there's no reason to live. Yep, your dude right here, Cash Money President, Weezy Baby, Carter 2 in stores. Shout out to Blow Magazine, DVD. It was great, man. Gangster. That's how I keep it. Yeah.